So, very good morning all. Okay. So, in the last session, we discussed the OSA model. So, we discussed up to presentation layer. So, we are continuing from the application layer now. Okay, already told that OSA model having 7 layers. So, it is we can say that it is a reference model. So, it was introduced by International Standard Organization. Okay, this is the OSA model, it is a reference model. So real time I told that there is a TCP/IP model, we are working on the TCP/IP model. So main purpose of the OSA model is how data is transmitting from one system to another system, how data is transmitting from data from one system to another system. Already told the present application layer is nothing but I told you what are the application we are using, that all under comes under the application layer. Okay, that all application come under the application layer. Okay. So presentation layer already told that it is involves three techniques. What were the three techniques? The encryption, data translation, encryption, compression. These are the three techniques are performing in the presentation layer. So what is the first one? Whatever that we are receiving data from the presentation layer, from the application layer to presentation layer. This presentation layer will take the data from application layer. The data is in the form of, alphabets and numbers. Okay, what was the alphabets and numbers? Suppose A, B, C, D, 6, 5, 7, 4, 9. This is the data we are receiving from the top layer to this presentation layer. So this data, whatever the data it is receiving from the presentation layer, this data should be in the form of, this data is in the form of alphabets and numbers. This alphabets and number is converted into machine understandable format. This alphabets and numbers is converted into machine understandable format. What was the machine understandable format? 100101. These are the machine understandable format. This is a binary format. I can say this is a binary format. So what are the data? What was the data sending from the application layer? That is normal data. That is combination of alphabets and numbers. So this data, when we are going to compress this data, first we have to change to binary code. What was the binary code? Suppose A, B, C, D, E, F, G, something is a code. And also 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. This is the data. This is received from the particular application layer. After receiving the application layer, we are converting it into machine understandable format, that is a binary code. So after performing this binary code, what we are doing data compression. Okay, what is data compression? Suppose the original message was 100101, like that the lengthy message is there. So when we are going to reduce the particular data bits or particular data, so when we are going for the compression, the data will not be changed. So what we suppose, example, suppose if you want to send compressed mail to anyone, in the data nothing will be changed. The file size should be reduced, but the data cannot be modified. The file size should be reduced, but data cannot be modified in the particular data compression technique. So after performing the data compression technique, one of the most important technique is encryption and decryption. What is encryption and decryption? So first data is received in the form of machine understandable, what was the format? That is binary format, that is in the alphabets and numbers. So after alphabets and numbers, this is converted into machine understandable format 10101. This is the format. So this 10101, this is a message, this is ASCII to FCD code. We can say this is a data is ASCII to FCD code. So when we are going to convert for the data compression, so 100, the file share should be, the data will not be modified, but the data will be reduced. When we are going to convert for the encryption and decryption, the same data, the sender side data is encrypted, receiver side data is decrypted. Okay, sender side data is encrypted, receiver side data is decrypted. So this, in which layer it is performing is encryption and decryption? SSL protocol. Okay, which layer it is performing this encryption and decryption technique? SSL protocol. What is SSL protocol? Secure socket layer protocol performing encryption and decryption technique. Which layer is performing encryption and decryption is performing by the secure socket layer. So these are two communicating devices. Okay, if we go to next slide, we will understand clearly. So finally, the presentation layer is responsible for compressing the data it receives from the application layer before delivering it to the layer 5. This helps to improve the speed and efficiency of communication by minimizing the amount of data that will be transferred. Understanding? So if the devices are communicating over encrypted connection, layer 6 is responsible for adding encryption on the senders and as well as decoding the encryption. So what was the presentation layer performing? It is performing three operations. One is data translation, data compression, data encryption, and data decryption. These are the three operations are performing in the particular presentation. If you go to next slide, session layer. So the data is now from application layer to presentation layer, presentation to session layer. So this session layer performs three important operations. One is authentication, authorization, and also session management. So before going to go for the three techniques, first we'll see this is a layer responsible for opening and closing the communication between the two devices. The time between when the communication is opened and closed is known as a session. So this session layer ensures that the session stays open long enough to transfer all the data being exchanged, and then the promptly closes the session order to avoid the wasting resources. So actually, what was the session? Generally, what was the session? Session is nothing but suppose if you want to establish a connection between one system to another system, what we have to do? Compulsory, we have to establish the session. What was the session? It is suppose if you want to transfer one mail to another user, what we have to do before that? We have to establish a connection. Then only it possible to send the communication through the two devices. So what was operations here we are performing? If you go to next slide, I'll show you. Previous slide. So in the session layer, what was it? Authentication, authorization, session management. Three techniques: authentication, authorization, session management. What is authentication? Authentication is nothing but suppose if you want to connect with one device to another device, first what we have to do? Authentication. So for session, suppose authentication is nothing but suppose there is a username and password. Okay, username and password. By using the valid credentials, we can give authentication by using the right username and right password. Okay, so if the username and by using the credentials it is good, so automatically the session will establish. Okay, the session will establish. After completion of this authentication, what was the next step? That is the authorization. So what is authorization? Authorization is nothing but we are establishing the authorization. Suppose authentication is nothing but already we established the connection. So by using the username and password, so if it is matching, it allows for the particular device. So after performing that one, suppose authorization is nothing but if I go to example in website, so many web pages will be there. Some web pages are accessible, some web pages are not authorized. So they will give that, so you are not authorized for this page. So some limitation will be there when we are going for the authentication and authorization. So that is the second step. The authorization is only for particular users only who are in the particular organization, they can access their authorization. So another one is session management. So what is happening? There are two systems. So after performing the authentication and authorization, what is happening? Session management. So transmitting, sending the messages, getting the acknowledgement, sending the message and getting the acknowledgement. So it is a process. When after finishing this everything, we have to close the session. After finishing transmitting it, then what we have to do in the session layer, the session is closing. So when the session was, what you have mentioned is the session layer ensures that the session stays open along to transfer the data being exchanged and then promptly closes the session in order to avoid the wasting resources. So in this way, the session management is established and session layer is performing. If you go to next slide, transport layer. So transport layer is mostly involved in TCP and UDP, transmission control protocol and user data graph protocol. What is TCP? It is a connection oriented protocol. UDP is a connectionless protocol. Okay, the transport layer provides services to the application layer and takes services from network layer. The data in the transport layer is referred to as a segments. So what I mentioned in the application layer, what I mentioned, the data is a normal data. Okay, the data is normal data. Coming to here, so in the nothing is changed in the presentation layer, the data is coming in the same thing. And session also coming like this. After coming to here data, the data is in the form of segments. So it is responsible for the end-to-end delivery. So the segments are responsible for end-to-end delivery of the complete message that transport the layer provides to acknowledgement of the successful data transmission, retransmit the data if an error is found. This transport layer involves most two things. One is transmission control protocol and UDP, user datagram protocol. So it is mostly involved in the segments. Segments is nothing but some particular message is there. So some sequence number is added and port number is added to particular message. Suppose if you see particular data is there, hello, H is one H data, it added some sequence number and port number, and also some sequence number and port number. So in this way the segments are added to the particular data. So here in the data is in the form, in the transport layer, the data is in the form of segments. So what is TCP? TCP is a connection oriented protocol. UDP is a connectionless protocol. You go to next slide. So in the TCP, actually what is connection oriented and what is connectionless? Suppose if you want to transmit any mail to the any user. So when we are sending the mail, we are getting the acknowledgement, means it is comes under the TCP. Okay, compulsory the acknowledgement is required. Coming to UDP, what is happening? Suppose audio streaming and video streaming, we are using UDP. Suppose if it is any shutdown also, again the retransmission will occurs automatically. For coming to TCP, compulsory we need acknowledgement. Without acknowledgement, we cannot understand that whether the file is received or not, whether the acknowledgement received or not. We cannot unable to say this thing. So this is, in this way, this TCP and UDP is important in the transport layer. Okay, coming to network layer. What is network layer? Network layer works for the transmission of the data from one host to other located in the different networks. It also takes care of the packets routing, selection of the shortest path to the transmit the packets from the number of routes available. The sender receiver address the places set by the network layer. Okay, actually this network layer most involved in the IP address. Internet protocol address. The network layer comes under the internet protocol address. Who will provide this network address? ISP will provide this IP address. What do you mean by ISP? Internet service providers. Who will provide this IP? Internet service providers. So we have so many internet service providers like Hathaway, Beam, all Airtel. These are all are the comes under telecom industry. So these we can say these are all are the providers, service providers of ISP. Okay. So it also takes the care of packages. So what I mentioned in the previous, then the data is in the form of segments. In the transport layer, the data is in the form of segments. Now here it is, data is in the form of packets. So here what we are adding in the packet, there we are adding some sequence number and port number. What do you mean by sequence number? Suppose sequence in the number, suppose when the data is coming from top to bottom, at that time when we are sending to the user, so the data will not receive in the form of exact, hello world will not receive exactly to the receiver. Why? Because there is not order format. If you want to maintain the order format, the sequence number will assemble the message in the correct order. In that reason, we are using the sequence number. Why we are using the sequence number? Suppose if you want to give the correct order to the particular message to deliver to the user, in that reason, we are using the sequence number. So what do you mean by port number? Port number is nothing but we have so many applications. Each and every application, they are having own port number. The port number will direct to the application. It will direct to the application. Sequence number, the whatever the message is there, it will arrange in the correct order. That is port number. Port number is nothing but it taking direct to the application. By using the port number, it will take the direct to the application. Okay. So that is about the sequence number and port number. In coming to here, the data is in the form of packets, segments to packets. Okay, segments to packets. Okay, packets is, what is packets? Packets are nothing but sender side IP address is added. Before that, what we are adding, for particular hello world, what we are adding sequence number and port number. Each and every datagram, we are adding sequence number and port number. Coming to here in the network layer, in the IP packets, we are adding sender side IP address and receiver side IP address is added. Okay, sender side IP address. At the same time, receiver side IP address is added. Okay, so in the network layer, most important thing is routing. What is routing? The network layer protocol determines which route is suitable from source to destination. This function, network layer, also routing. So the routing will take the responsibility to send the data from one router to another router to by a particular receiver. So in that reason, routing is the most important function in the network layer. So the network layer protocol determines which route is suitable for the source to destination. So we have so many routes: open shortest path first, border gateway protocol, handle to intermediary system to intermediary system. These are all are the protocols we have. By using this protocol, we can find what was the shortest path to particular packet is traveling from one source to another destination. So in this way, these are important of routing mechanism we are using. So logical addressing is most important. Is logical addressing nothing but in order to identify each device internetwork uniquely. Network layer defines and addressing the scheme. The sender receivers the IP address are placed in the header. So actually, what are the message? What are the packet? In the header format itself mentioned that sender's IP address and receiver IP address. So by assigning the sender's IP address and receiver IP address, we can say the packet will move to the direct to the destination. There is no problem to send particular data to any user. So in that reason, we are mentioning this sender IP address and receiver IP address. So segments in network layer is referred as a packets. Okay, segments in the network layer. Okay, segments, where the segment? Segments is in the transport layer. Okay, in the network layer, the segment we can call it as a packets. So network layer is implemented by networking devices. Okay, network layer is implemented by networking devices such as routers. So routers, we have some routers names like Beetel, routers, SIM Beetel, like there are number of routers. Okay, by each and every router having some particular functionality to transfer the data from one system to another system. Okay, so if you go to next slide, data link layer. So starting the what in the data link layer, the data is in the form of frames. Okay, data is in the form of frames. So frames is nothing but, so whatever the data, so we are adding some data link layer, physical address we are adding the MAC address of the particular systems. Okay, by you finding, we are, before that we are adding the IP address, senders and receiver. Before that we are adding the port number and CPS number. In this data link layer, we are adding the MAC address, physical address of the system. By adding the physical address of the system, what will happen? Automatically it will take the direct to the application. No, so the data link layer is responsible for the node-to-node delivery. So this data link layer is node-to-node delivery, nothing but system-to-system delivery. I mentioned that in the reason it is a MAC address. Okay, the main function of this layer is to make the shoot data transfer error-free from one node to another. Okay, the physical layer, when a packet arrives the network, it is a responsibility of data link layer to transmit to the host using the MAC address. This is the most, so that here in the data link layer, it is in the form of frames. If you go to next layer, we will finish partially. Okay, so the data link layer divides into, okay, if you go to next slide, so address resolution protocol, framing techniques, physical addressing, error control, flow control, access control. These are all of the techniques comes under the data link layer. So this we have separately, these all things comes under the data link layer. Packet in the data link layer is referred as a frame. Data link layer is handled by the network interface card. This is nothing but NIC, nothing but network interface card. So network interface card, device drivers, host machines. So switches, bridges are data link layer is there. So the data link layer, so before that layer, the routers are involved. Network layer, routers are involved. Here, switches and bridges are involved in the data link layer devices. If you go to next layer, another bottom layer, that is the first layer, physical layer, it is a layer one. So the data is in the form of bits, okay? In the bits, bit synchronization, bitrate control, physical topologies, transmission mode, hub repeaters. These are all comes under the particular. Okay, thank you.